Hello developers, and welcome back to Elixir Pro. In this video, we're going to continue our series on CodeWars exercises. We are going to do, once again, an exercise of Q6 because we are on the road to Q5. So let's get started after the intro.
So let's get started. Let's go back to our katas. Let's go for 6 Elixir. Sort by popularity, and there we go. We did all these first ones. This is like that series that we're not gonna do. Let's go for bit counting. What is this bit counting? Write a function that takes an integer as input and returns a number of bits that are equal to the binary representation of that number. You can guarantee that the input is non-negative. I think there's an Elixir function for this one. I think it should be easy. Let's go for it. Lib. So this one here, .ex. _ counting. Bit. Mod. Okay. Let me go make this. Test mod. Now we can start this. Let's grab this one here. Let's put it here. If I'm not mistaken, there is a function for this one, a built-in function in Elixir. Integer dot two. I think there's a string to integer, and we can pass let's maybe start our IX. Let's go for it. Integer dot two. Let's go actually search for this thing. I think there's one in Elixir language, Elixir integer. Docs module. Okay, I'll have it. We go for integer, and let's go for base digits. Returns the order these are forgiven. Okay, so it's basically like this. Let's check if that's actually what I'm going to do. So we're going to do like 1, 2, 3, 4 integer to digits. I think it's just digits. And now we're going to digits returns if we pass digits and then pass 2 and in dot 2 a string and string dot two. Oh, it's a string representation. What do we have to return? It's 3 over there. And the representation of that number guarantee. So we're going to be to 0 is 4. Oh, it counts the ones. So that's the enum dot filter. F at 1 = 1. Enum dot sum. That's it. That's our algorithm. Oops, I got the wrong one. It's this one here. Copy. Should be n, and we can do like this. That's pretty good. So let's run our tests. Count bits. This should be bit counting. Same here. Let's run our test once again. And there we have it, our first test passing. So let's grab this one here. Let's go and paste it here. Let's indent. Let's attempt. And it worked. Okay, integers, enumbered sum. Oh, we didn't even filter. Yeah, that's right. Okay, so let's go for our next kata. So bit counting is done. Fibonacci sequence. 1, 1, 2. So this should be the sum of the last two. This should be the sum of these ones. I think that's a good way so we can implement this in Elixir. Let's go for it. Maybe I have done this in the past. Just let me confirm that. Fibonacci. Yeah, we have Fibonacci down there. Okay, let's try to create a Fibonacci 2. I did this thing like a long time ago. I remember some tricky things here related to the performance. So the Fibonacci sequence 2 dot, that's it. 2.ex. Okay. Mod. Let's grab the Fibonacci. Here we have a spec saying that receives three numbers. So it's the first three numbers, I believe. I guess, what's this thing here, new, now let's create test mod, let's grab this thing here, let's paste it, let's go back here, actually, okay. So if I pass 1 on 1 and then should return that thing over there. Okay, so we need to generate the sequence, right? Okay, what I'm going to do is actually I'm going to call Fibonacci with the it's a signature, which is that thing here with our signature actually. Signature with the number of elements that we are requesting and our accumulator. And actually I'm going to put the accumulator first. Okay, now we have a Fibonacci, so we can defp Fibonacci sequence accumulator signature. Actually we can now parametric on that signature, so we can number 1, number 2, and number 3. And we can say the amount of elements, okay? And we can then stop once that thing reaches 0, maybe. Okay, let's try that. So what we are going to do, we are going to... actually, our Fibonacci sequence, our accumulator could be started with our signature, but we need to with all those numbers there. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So this should be like this. We should start like this. Maybe. And we should return like this. This should be our signature. And actually, I'm going to put these numbers inside there. Okay. I think we're fine. And now we have our signature. Mm-hmm. So what we are going to do is actually, we are going to call Fibonacci. This should be 3, 2, and 1. Because we're going to do a random.reverse later. We're going to pattern match on the sequence, which will be the sum of numbers. So sum is going to receive number 1 plus number 2 plus number 3. And I'm going to put like the sum here and the accumulator. And we are gonna pass the number 2, number 3, and the sum. And this is going to be n minus minus 1. Okay. And let's call a guard clause here, saying that once this thing reaches 0, we are going to return the accumulator. Okay, what's this? And if Fibonacci 3. What is this? Not an array 3 function. Whoops, Fibonacci. No, I put the sequence here. Okay, and we don't care what we're gonna have here. Okay, let's recompile and let's do Fibonacci sequence 2, the Fibonacci. We're going to pass that one, that number's there. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and then we are gonna pass 10. And this returned a little more than what we expected to. Oh yeah, okay, I already got it. So this should be enum.reverse accumulator. And this should be all the times they're passing three numbers, right? Yeah. So n minus 3. Compile, and if I do like this, I think we got it. So let's go and run this test here. And Fibonacci 2. Fibonacci 2. What was the reason? What was the issue? Undefined function Fibonacci 2. And that's a Fibonacci with two numbers. Oh, it's alias and not import. Now I think it will work and we can go back here. Open once again and let's run just these first ones here. It did work. We had some problems here. So I think all these should be working if I'm not mistaken. Okay, this one here, we should put the guard clause, so we can actually create a Fibonacci with, we can do the 111. Actually, we can do for 1. This should return number 1 in a list. We can do the same thing for number for 2. This should be this one here. And we can do the same. Oops, this should be 1 and 2, right? Number 1. And this should be best 3. This should be number 3. Now, if you pass 300, 200, and 100, it should return 0. Oh, because if we pass 0, return an empty list. Okay, so this time we don't care about this one or this one. Then we don't care about the last one. And we also don't care about this whole thing here. And I think now if I recompile this one here, it should work as well. But you go for this one here. was quite fast. Actually, I think we did something wrong in the first time that we are executing. Okay, so this is our Fibonacci representation. Let me grab this one here. Let's go and paste it here. Let's attempt. And it worked, so we can submit. Stream.unfold, man, this one here is awesome. I really need to learn how to work with streams. Stream.unfold, I'm gonna put this one here at the bottom. Unfold, it's going to generate, it's gonna take ABC, it's going to generate A, and then it's going to take this one here. Stream.unfold us. Let's go for it. Elixir stream unfold. So then the unit accumulator successive values are generated by calling next fun previous accumulator. Let's return a tuple with the current value in the next accumulator. So since it's new, the first argument is going to go for the accumulator, and then it's going to call this one before. That's going to for, and once we turn new, once it returns new, it finishes, and then, oh no, not necessarily. Because, we, no, yeah, it finishes once received. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. Okay, we have like another kata. Let's go for the next one. So, dubstep. Yeah, let me put this thing a little bit bigger. Polycarpus worked as a DJ in the best Berlin nightclub, and he uses often dubstep music in his performance. Recently, he has decided to take a couple of songs and make a dubstep remixes from them. Let's assume that a song consists of a number of words that don't contain whoop. To make a dubstep remix of this song, Polycarpus inserts certain numbers of words whoop before the first word of the song. The number may be zero. After the last word, the number may be zero in between the words. So he put like whoops in the sentence. At least one between any pair of neighbor words. And then the boy glues together all the words including whoop in one string and plays the song. For example, this song IMX transformed remix as whoop 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 I whoop M whoop whoop X and cannot transform into whoop whoop I am whoop X. Oh my. Within Johnny heard a Polycarpus of the stack, but since he's into more music, he decided to find out what was the initial song that Polycarpus remixed. Help Johnny restore the original song. We are the champions, my friend. Okay, let's try like based on the test because I'm not sure if I understood what we should be doing like in this exercise. So it's a dubstep. Let's go for it. dubstep.ex. Mod, this should be dubstep. We have a song decode. Let's paste it here. Make it a little bit bigger. Okay, let's create the test file. This should be test mod. Let's paste this thing here. And this should be dubstep. Dubstep, dubstep. Okay, so let's make TDD guides us in our implementation. The only thing that I'm gonna do first is get a song, and I'm going to remove all the whoop string dot remove or replace actually the word whoop with nothing. Actually, with a space. Okay, and let's run this first test here. And okay, we already got our first one. Let's run this one here. And you see we have, okay, so we can do a regex. So we can do a string.replace. Like, I think we need to get, I never recall how it is space regex representation. So space is dash matches space. So we can do like this, like as many times as we want, and we are going to replace with a single space. So let's run this thing here. And actually we can do maybe at least one or many times, and now it worked. And let's run this one here, and now we do a string.trim. Okay, let's run this time, and it worked. Okay, let's try to see if this is the actual algorithm, because I didn't quite understand much out of the description. Let's attempt. Yep, and it worked. So yeah, that's our algorithm. Oh, you just the whoop. So as many times as you could. I think let's see what this regex actually is saying. So if you go to regex 101, I think we can paste our regex here at the top, and it's going to quantifier. So matches one and unlimited times the thing inside here. So you're going to match this thing as many times as you want. And we're going to replace that thing with just one space. Pretty nice, pretty nice. Okay, so let's go for our next kata. Okay, next kata is build pile of cubes. So your task is to construct a building which will be a pile of n cubes. The cube at the bottom will have the volume of n exponential 3. And the cube above will have the volume of n minus 1, okay, exponential 3. So it will continue down until we reach the 1 times 3, which is the like our guard class. You're given a total of m buildings, being given m. Can you find the number of n cubes you find in the building? The parameter might be, okay, so let's see, if we put, and these things are a little bit awful. So we have like this thing here, and minus one, because this thing is like tremendously big. Your task is to construct a building which will be a pile of n cubes. The cube at the bottom will have the volume of, okay. And the cube above will have like n minus 1. So to reach the top, you give the volume of, okay. You are given the total volume m of the building. So it will be the sum of all the other volumes, if I'm not mistaken. Being given m, which is the volume, you find the number of cubes you will have to build. The parameter of the function will be find n b and b minus 1 and b. Will be an integer m, and you will return such as okay. I think this is a math problem. I think we can actually. Mm-hmm. I'm going to play around with in a sheet of paper, and I'll be back in a second. Okay, so I could not actually find the solution. I think we're gonna go for recursion function, and hopefully it will be enough for us to so that we pass the performance test. So let's build this thing here. So build pile of cubes. Let's go back here and close this one here. Of cubes.ex. I haven't created this thing before, right? Okay. Let's create this one here. Let's grab this thing here. Let's test mod. Let's paste it. And this should be alias. This should be build pile of cubes. Why are we returning minus 1? Okay. Current function will be integer if each index is or minus 1 if does not. Okay. Okay, so what I was thinking about doing is actually we are gonna sum the n exponential by 3 until you reach the number. If we pass that, probably it's because we should return minus 1, and if we reach the point, we should return the number, the n that we are summing. Okay, so the name of the function should be find n b, and what we are gonna do. So let's put an accumulator here. Be fine, and B, we're gonna put an accumulator in M. Okay, and just for example, let's actually create something more easily. Let's go for test foo, and if we pass fine and B, and B of, let's say, 1 times 3 is like 1, times 3 is 8, it was 9. 9 times 30 to 27, it's 36. So let's put like 36 here. And you want to assert the number of cubes is 3. Okay, so assert. And there we go. So let me diff-def-p. We're going to find nb passing our accumulator. And we're going to be passing M. Okay, so our accumulator actually will start in 0. No, actually it starts in 0. Starts in 1. That's the cubes, right? It's not an accumulator, it's number of cubes. So this should be num of cubes. Okay. So, and we need to pass as well the the sum here. So it would be the number of cubes, the our sum. What should we need our sum? No, I think we don't need our sum. We can actually subtract from the amount there. Okay, so what we are gonna return here is with find NB with num of cubes plus one. And we should return here M minus do we have a way to like exponential in Elixir? Should be minus num of cube. Minus num of cubes. I think it's Po. I think we have Po. Elixir Po. Elixir exponent example. Math.po. Okay. So if I do like this, should return 8. And I think this should be should we need to, if I do the same thing, math.po, and we can do like this. Okay. And we can here now dot minus 612. Does it work? Yeah, it works. Okay. So this thing here should be math.po passing num of cubes 3. Yeah. And once this thing here, when m, actually, if this thing reaches 0, we're going to return number of cubes, right? But if m, when m minor than 0, do minus one, num of cubes, so we actually don't care this thing here. Let's try our solution. So build fibs dot find nb passing 36. It returned minus one. Why? So let's go for it. So we're gonna return n one here, and this should be one here, right? So this should return now 36 minus one, 35. 35, and now we have 2 here, 2. And now we have 2, 35 minus 8, 27. So I have 3. Now we have 3, it's going to return 4 here, and we have 37 minus 27, and this returns 0, and then it goes for this case here, and number of cubes minus one. Okay, it broke our solution. Let's see what we are. So let's go inspect M. Let's put this thing back. It should be build pi of cubes dot find nb of 36. Compile. And again, build cubes 36. So 36, 25. Oh, 0.0. Now 3. So there we have it. I think that's our algorithm. And maybe let's hopefully expect that this thing does not break in performance issues, because I think there is a better it's this one here. Damn it, I don't know why it's that test is not grabbing our solution. Let's put this one here. Let's attempt. 1, 2, and it failed. So it should be so which is the one that we put it? Solution. Right. Okay, let's try to run our solution here. Maybe I miswrote something. We just remove this thing here, and this should be an import. Let's try this one. Oh, I deleted the wrong thing. Port. Let's run this one here. All the tests passed. I think we spent like a lot of time here, and we might get like a wrong thing in our implementation. Let's put lightning once again. And hopefully this thing, so let's actually run our tests. Here they are passing. Okay. So this is DM. Let's go for this thing. So let me paste this thing here. Actually, we don't need that. We can just grab this M here. And the solution should be this one, and the solution. Okay. Let's run this test here. And it's passing. Grab this one here. This one. Let's run this test. And it's working. And the number that they're not even saying me which is the input. Oh man, I think this test is working. I don't know why. Let's check the solutions. Is basically our solution. And this thing is the same as ours. N minus 1 is lesser than 0. If not, just change the place of the accumulator. It's not even using the accumulator. Yeah, we're not using the accumulator as well. Oh, damn it. Okay, let's go. I'm gonna end this one here. I got a little bit pissed. So, thanks for watching. Until next time. Bye.